Hi guys, welcome to Pop Dance Live. Today we are so excited to have two, not just one, but two of the Tremaine faculty members. One is Tiffany Maher. You may have seen her as Christine on Hit the Floor, or Dancing for J.Lo, or Pitbull, Ariana Grande, Disney shows, yada, yada, yada. Amazing, beautiful girl.
And many, many more, as well as we have Tony Bellissimo here. He's danced for Chris Brown, Rihanna, JT, to name a few. You've seen him on So You Think You Can Dance, and he's been part of the Step Up movie franchise. You guys, we are so excited. Please help us welcome Tiffany and Tony.
Yay! Hi.
Thank you for having us.
In sync. Yeah. So you guys are obviously friends and work with each other. Yeah. And how long have you known each other?
We have known each other since I was 13.
Yeah.
And you were 17.
I came to Tremaine for the first time. It was the 25th anniversary, and she was the outgoing dancer of the year. And man, my group came in to try to take the whole championship, and we did.
We did.
In the 25th anniversary.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Yeah. That's when we met. Very cool. So. Yeah.
And now you guys both go on tour with them every year.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. There's myself, Tiffany, Megan, Sanit, Derek Schroeder, Laurie Johnson, Carrie LeGrand, Emily Zachary, and legendary Mr. Joe Tremaine as
Marty
well.
Du.
Fabulous.
And I cannot forget my mentor, Mr. Marty Du.
Marty!
Mr. Marty Du.
Yes.
I see you.
I got you.
I love it. And you guys also worked on the movie together, right?
Yeah, we've done a few things together. Yeah. Step Up 4 and Trolls recently.
Right.
Very
and we
cool.
both did So You Think.
So You Think You Can Dance.
Yeah.
And then you did Rock of Ages.
Rock of Ages.
I did an acting scene in Rock of Ages where myself and Julianne Hough, I welcomed Julianne Hough to L.A. and then I rip her off pretty much.
Oh, nice.
In my glorified acting scene, my big debut on the big screen is speaking. So it was cool. But,
Very cool. So obviously you guys are dancers, but you're starting to kind of dabble into acting as well.
A little bit here and there. Yeah. I think it just raised to be a triple threat is the best thing, you know. And that's what I was raised, is to do everything, perform and try.
So. And you got to be Christine on Hit the Floor.
Yeah, it was an amazing opportunity. So we were hired as dancers, and then they gave us character name. They gave us lines every season. It was really cool, awesome experience. Love James LaRosa. He's a director. But my first job out here was actually a Disney Channel pilot, and I was an actor, and that's what brought me out here originally. It didn't get picked up because they were spending all their money on Teen Beach movie, so it didn't get picked up. But from Hit the Floor, Dean Cain asked me to be in a Hallmark Christmas movie, so that was really cool. It was called Merry Xmas, and I played Discreet. And recently just did a short film, and yeah, it's just dance has kind of led me to awesome opportunity, so I'm forever grateful for that.
Very awesome.
Yeah.
And we also understand that you guys both started on So You Think You Can Dance.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
How was you guys' experience on each of the shows?
I'll go first since I was earlier season.
Season five?
So my friends joke with me because I auditioned for season four.
Okay.
I made season five. Uh-huh. I was eliminated for season five. And then I danced more on season 7, 8, 9, 10, 11,
oh my
and
God.
Continued on.
You have probably been on more seasons than So You Think than anybody.
You're right. Yes, I have. But I still am not, you know, I didn't make my great impact as for my own season. But.
So I have to ask you, because what was the whole thing with Nigel?
Okay.
What happened? I know everybody else wants to know, too. Yeah. What was the real story?
So Nigel told me in Miami for my audition season five that he didn't think I came back prepared. He didn't think I came back as improved as he would like me to be. At the time, the panel was Mary Murphy and Tice D'Ario, and they pushed me through to go to choreography to save me. And I'm very grateful for that. But Nigel was like, I don't know. I think you should just go home. So I was like, it's not good. Mm-hmm. So I made it through the choreography section, and he actually was like, here's your ticket. I don't know how you did it. You're going to Vegas. Great. So I go to Vegas, and that's when I debuted my solo, which was to Somebody's Watching Me. And I took a newspaper, and I put Nigel's face in the newspaper, in the briefcase, in my jacket, and did this whole, like, Funk Styles solo, exposing Nigel as to say to him, listen, I know who you are, and I respect you, but I know you're watching me, and I'm here to say I'm up to the test, and I'm not afraid of you. I'm ready to go.
Calling him out.
Let's go.
And
still watching me. But the thing was that, you know, I went to the show, and he even had some advice for me after I made top 20 that, you know, he's like, you're not going to do as well as the others because you're just not as good as them. But your body, if your body can do what your mind could do, you'd be really great. So
he did not say that.
He did. Wow. And I was taken back by it, and I was like, I don't know if he really likes me or not, but I can't tell. And
wow.
You know, and then I was actually eliminated first, and I was crushing. But at the same time, it was, a great opportunity to be a part of the show. But if we're 20 years old at the time and thinking that SYTYCD dance is the pinnacle of your career, little did I know it was a lily pad hopping into my next adventure. So
absolutely.
It was cool.
Absolutely, and those kind of things are what make you a better dancer, a stronger character,
yeah,
and really
sure.
build your fuels your fire to mm-hmm. like kind of go and do what you want to do. Yeah, I mean, it's a stepping stone for
it's
sure.
It's the best, yeah. And I always tell people, especially when I'm teaching on Tremaine, because you deal with a lot of things. The fact that we're teaching on Tremaine and the kids are constantly, they face rejection, not only in the dance room with peers and cliques, but you're also dealing with auditions now at this young age. And mm-hmm. they also have to, they are a competition and they see groups better than them or worse than them and they have to compete and mentally figure that out. Mm-hmm. And not everyone at Tremaine gets a trophy. Not everyone gets a pin. We, first, second, and third, Joe Tremaine's philosophy, you have to earn it. It holds some water, like the Olympics. If you work for it, you're gonna get it. And if you don't, mm-hmm. guess what? It's not a defeat. It's only an incentive to work harder, yeah. incentive to continue to move forward. So, yes, the defeat of my defeat on SYTYCD Dance was big for myself. It wasn't that.
Yeah.
It wasn't my story to make it all the way through. My story was to lose and then continue forward.
Well, it wasn't a loss, that's
but,
for sure.
Yeah.
And at 20 years old, you had already succeeded. So
true.
How about that? So it's perspective for sure.
And true. He forgets that he made the top 20.
Yeah.
You know what
right.
I mean? That is like, it is
almost
such a hard process.
So hard.
It's such a hard process.
Yeah.
It's
what
exhausting.
What was your experience, Tiffany,
on
the show?
It was an experience for sure. I was in my first year of college and that's what I had worked for my whole life growing up. I had to get the best grades. I studied my butt off, the right SAT scores. I was in every club I could possibly try and be in. That took a lot of my time, like helping out organizations. But then I was in college and the audition came up and my dream was always to move to LA. And I thought, what better way than to maybe like use this as a step to get out there? So I auditioned in Atlanta, made it to the choreography round, went to Vegas. And shockingly made it to the top 20 because I had watched the Atlanta episode air and they didn't show me for 1 second. So I was like, all right, I had this whole watch party with my dance studio and they didn't show 1 second of me. And I was like, all right, guys, I guess I'm not going to make the show.
Wait,
there we go.
So you didn't know? Like, you didn't know until the actual show airs whether you were top 20 or not?
Yeah, and people don't know that, but...
I didn't realize that
even. So I auditioned in January. Vegas week was April. It started filming like it started airing right after Vegas
right.
week. But I had to wait until like the middle of June to find out if I even made it.
Oh my God, the anticipation.
Oh, so I had a watch party with my entire dance studio and they didn't show me once and I was like, all right, that was fun, It was a great experience, yeah.
And then what happens? And then did you all of a sudden get that phone call?
Well, I went back to Green Mile and I remember my season. I was like, gosh, there were so many amazing people. My season, like Whitney and Lindsay, who are both killing it on Dancing with the Stars right now, and my partner George and Cyrus, who's just a phenom in what he does. Mm-hmm. There was just so many, Keon, he can literally touch the ceiling with his leaps, There's just so many incredible people. And so I went to Green Mile, and I was so shocked to hear that I was in the top 20, and it was crazy. And I actually found out that they called Mia Michaels because I had worked with her on Rock of Ages, and they asked like how my work ethic was, if they thought I'd be good for the show, and
wow.
she gave
She gave the thumbs up.
So that was
good.
When I found that out after, I was like, wow, that means a lot,
know,
because Mia Michaels is like Mia Michaels.
Mm-hmm. So you had already done some professional jobs already before you went on to SYTYCD Dance.
Yeah, I had done Rock of Ages, Step Up Revolution, both in Miami, and then I had done a Disney Channel pilot, and I had made it to like the end of a Fly Girls audition.
Oh,
yeah,
fun.
It was between me and this other girl when they were gonna redo it. So
yeah.
It's us two, and Nappy Tabs was on that. And they were in Vegas week, so I was like hoping, I was like, maybe they remember me. Yeah,
you would
so
be
then
a great Fly
show.
Girl, by the way.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks. It was like, I was like, that would be amazing. I love J.Lo. But yeah, so then I did the show. It was a great experience. It was the hardest experience. I thought I was going home every week. He knows this. Because, like I said, they didn't show me at all, and everybody had this story. Everybody already had a fan base building from April.
Yeah.
No one knew who I was the first show. And so I go through every week, and the thing I knew, like I was confident in my versatility and my perseverance to fight through anything, because no matter what obstacle and heartache and whatever comes my way, I know I'm gonna make it through. So I just kept pushing, kept fighting, and I was exhausted. I mean, the last week I literally could only drink liquids because I was so dead.
Oh,
they had to like give us a shot in our butt. It's like
a B12 shot.
Oh yeah, I mean, and a flu one because someone had the flu.
Oh boy.
But I ended up getting runner up on the show.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it was just, I mean, it taught me so much. It was like the biggest intensive you could ever go to,
sure.
You know?
Yeah.
And
sure.
Taught me a lot about myself, and I think got me prepared to move out here, and that's what kind of pushed me to come.
So you think you can dance is such a crazy experience. I've heard from so many dancers. I mean, especially, I mean, you clearly had some experience in the professional world prior to, but if you're coming from like, you know, wherever you've been living, not in LA, in a big metropolitan city, and then you get on this TV show and all of a sudden there's this whole world of other stuff that doesn't come with, that you didn't know was gonna come with just dancing on the show.
The outside world, actually.
Yeah, the publicity aspect of it, and oh, sure, the comments.
They tell you, too.
Yeah,
the producers come
read.
In, the producers say, do not read.
Mm-hmm.
Like any good rebel, I think the opposite of what they
say. I didn't read, I didn't go on YouTube.
Good,
because
good.
I did, and it was probably part of my downfall because I mentally got upset because people were so nasty. People are so nasty.
There are haters out there. There will always be haters.
I didn't understand. I was like, you don't even know me. Like, you haven't even seen me dance yet. And they're like already just disqualifying me. And I end up, you know, getting mentally.
So, what do you guys do to just plow through that and say, no, like, sure, you may think I'm a bad dancer, but I know I am.
Yeah, what do you do to persevere? Like you say, push through.
I mean, My whole philosophy now is if you can't say it to my face, then I don't believe it. So.
You heard it here first.
I think for me, what got me through is like I knew, like growing up, like I said, like whether it's school or dance, whatever it was, like I worked my butt off. Like Cyrus, one of my best friends, he's a phenom as an animator. Mm-hmm. But when I was growing up, like I didn't want to be known as a jazz dancer or a hip hop dancer or a tap dancer. So like I trained in everything I could, whenever I could. I went to every intensive I could go to, all the conventions. So going in there, I was just like, I've worked so hard. I know I can work so hard. I knew, like, people call me passion queen. I just love dancing with all of my heart, and I can't live without it. So I was just trying to show, like, America, like, please give me this opportunity to show you how much I love it. And, you know, it's what's helped me through so many things in my life. And I'm a big quote girl, and never let the fear of striking out keep you from playing the game was something that I had to say to myself every day. Like, you know, today's gonna be a hard day. You're gonna have to go on that stage not knowing if you're going home, but just give it everything you got, and that's all you can do, so.
That's great, I love that. Yeah. What was maybe something that happened or a moment in your careers, your young careers, that maybe was a turning point or a shift, or that you knew this is what I have to do in my life, this is what I want to do, and obviously dancing has led to all these other things, which is fantastic.
Yeah.
But what was that moment, that defining moment?
Go ahead.
Oh, I have to think.
Last time.
I have to think. That pivotal moment. I'd have to say, like, in my career, like, So You Think definitely is what gave me the drive and gave me like, okay, go out and move to LA. But I think I honestly think my first job, Rock of Ages, I mean, I was going from my senior year of high school, it was finals week, I remember AP exams.
Wow.
And I was going, I remember I went to this audition not knowing anything, and they were like, Mia Michaels is holding this audition. I thought it was a little rock movie, that's what they said. And
wow.
So, I mean, I was the youngest one on set because you had to be 18 and up. I had just turned 18, March 29th. It started like April, the beginning of April.
Wow.
And so it was just, I remember we rehearsed. Yeah.
Wow.
We rehearsed, and I remember like my first day being a dancer, Russell Brand walks in and is like, hey, what's up? I'm Russell Brand. Are you one of the dancers? And I was like, yeah. Like our first week we had the reading, and this just like being the person, like Mia Michaels was the choreographer, and there was like the pole dancers, and there was the people that weren't. There was five, and she was like, who thinks that they could do this? And I raised my hand not knowing. She's like, okay, go on the center one. Like my first day on a job,
yes,
you know,
fearless.
Yeah, and,
yes.
And I think that just going through that whole experience, because it was with Mia Michaels, who is going to make you tougher than anything.
Oh yes,
and I'm so grateful for that. But every day, like someone didn't show up the next day.
Wow.
So it was like every single day, it was like, am I going to be getting the email tomorrow for rehearsals? And she was flying people out from LA. And then like she had me teaching Brooke Lipton and Joey Dowling and Courtney Galliano and Jamie Goodwin the choreography. And it was just like, I was an 18-year-old girl who just graduated from high school. And, you know, I was learning from Chris Judd and Will Wingfield and Michael Higgins. It was his 100th movie. About SAG and residuals and all this.
Love it.
Tom Cruise is on
Legend.
Set. So I think, I mean, I think that experience was just like something that was like, I get to do what I love for a living. Mm-hmm. So
you got thrown into the lion's
den. Yeah,
like
definitely.
Shot right in.
So that was definitely, and Adam Shankman, of course, he's the best to work with. So
yeah,
how about you?
Nice. Shankman's the greatest.
Yeah, he's the greatest.
He's crazy, Shankman. Is that Shankman?
Shankman.
Oh, Adam, you crazy man.
Yeah.
I love him.
He was on your season, so you think.
He was on my season. He actually was on the week that I got kicked off. He came up to me and he told me, he goes, you know, those Zephyrs kicked you off, not me. Adam was also the person who booked me on my first job, which was the Academy Awards.
Perfect.
Opening with Neil Patrick Harris. And then that led me into Step Up franchise, where I actually played the body double for Step Up 3. I played for Rick Melambry, the actor. I played his dance double. And it was the beginning of the career. But my the pivotal moment for me, I think, was the Vanguard performance, the VMAs with Justin Timberlake.
Mm. Nice.
15 minutes of Justin Timberlake's music mashed together.
That was the longest performance I think I've ever seen. Mm-hmm. Like, you guys
besides
must have
Beyonce
been dying.
Was last year. Beyonce, she came out and did her own thing, and you know, she's like, my baby sister Rihanna being, you know, Vanguarded, and I'm gonna come perform. 25-minute set.
But it was amazing.
It was both. Rihanna's sets was fantastic. You know, shout out to Hi-Hat and Kelvet. Beyonce's was fantastic. But Justin's, working for Marty Kadelka. Mm-hmm. I mean, I've been studying him for years. My first concert I've ever seen in my entire life, never had the money to go see concerts. My first concert was Future Sex Love Sound in Buffalo, New York, and at the HSBC. And I went to go see that show in the round, and it was just like
amazing.
Oh, amazing, amazing. And it's always funny because whenever I find someone's opposing energy is opposing me in these kind of events, I conquer it. So like at the concert, I was dancing and someone was throwing ice at the back of my head.
What?
Yeah, it was weird.
Rude. They're haters.
Haters.
About love, people. We need to love and dance.
That's what I say too. Love,
that's
please.
That's it. You know, and then my dad's at the concert. He's on high alert, looking for who is throwing stuff at me. But I'm talking to myself. I'm like, this person. One day I'm gonna dance for this guy, for Justin Timberlake, and this person is gonna be eating their ice.
And
flash
forward.
In Buffalo. Forward. And the same thing happened in Step Up. I went to go see the first Step Up movie, and I left the theaters like, I'm gonna be in this movie. I have to be in one of these movies. And some guys were, you know, harassing me in the parking lot as I was dancing through the parking lot. And I looked back and I looked at them and I was like, man, it's not worth it. Not worth it, but one day they're gonna, I'm gonna be up there.
Yeah, wow.
That happened too. I was like, all
right,
cool.
All right, so what, you were Step Up 3,
I Step Up 3, 4, and I was asked to be in 5, yeah.
Wow.
It was cool.
And
it was very cool.
Maybe future ones.
Maybe, right. Who knows. But the VMA performance, not only was it with Marty and then all my friends, you know, the people I respected, people I've watched growing up, coming out and transition from Buffalo to the professional LA scene, to then, you know, Justin Timberlake. This is like the man. Like this is this is my Frank Sinatra. This is my
absolutely.
Wow, this is really happening. And how I met him is he introduced himself to me. Mm-hmm. I was like, this guy, what? And I'm a big sneakerhead, so I love sneakers. And Nick Bass had a really cool pair of sneakers on at the time, which if you know Nick Bass, then you know your dance. If you don't, then you need to do some research. So Nick Bass was in the room, and he had some dope sneakers. And I was like, those are fresh. And I started tying my sneakers, and another pair of amazing sneakers, unreleased, walked right by me. And I was like, oh, my God, look at those. I look up, and there's JT. And he goes, down, he goes, what's up, man? I'm Justin. And I go, yeah, no shit. I was like, I know who you are. And before the end of the rehearsal, you know, Kadelka, he's like, he has me tell my whole like nickname story and everything to Justin, and I loved it. And then the whole secret the whole week was that NSYNC was gonna join us for the performance. So now I'm like,
it was a secret.
My God. I'm like, I'm seven again, and NSYNC just came out.
Wow.
And I'm like, this is too crazy.
That's awesome.
Can I just hear a nickname story? You have a nickname?
I have a nickname, yeah.
What's your nickname?
Oh my gosh.
Come on.
Okay, so my nickname is Tonte.
Tonte.
Yeah.
That's exactly
what
you can say.
Tonte, don't play.
You can say any way you want. The funniest story, and I'll sum it up as fast as this. I grew up in the 90s. I love the movie Hook, starring Robin Williams. Yep. You know, love you. Robin Williams, late Robin Williams. So I watched that movie religiously as a kid. I love Peter Pan. I love that whole story. Love everything about it. I go to play poker one evening with my buddies, and Marty was in the house, and Nick Wilson, and Ivan Kumaiv, and Brian Tanaka were all hanging out. And name drops, bang, whoa. So I walk into this game, and I see someone I do not know. So I don't know this person. I see the back of his head, and I say hello to everybody, and I turn, and Marty's like, do you guys know each other? And I go, no, what's up, man? And as I'm about to shake hands with this unknown character, our hands clasp, and I look at him, and I go, through my movie index, and I go, holy crap, that's Rufio from
Dante Bosco.
Exactly. Dante Bosco.
Rufio.
And he goes, what's up, man? My name is Dante. I go, what's up, man? My name is Tonte. And I go, oh no!
Please.
And I go, no! No, 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 that's not my name. And I'm squeezing this man's hand, shaking his hand like, no, and I look at Marty and I'm like, no, and Marty goes, yes.
From
forever,
now on, Tonte.
Your name is Tonte.
Sure.
So if you truly know me, if they truly know me, people call me Tonte. If not, like Marty's Kadaka, his daughter Lucy, I am Uncle Tonte. If someone calls me Tony, she has no idea who he's talking about.
Nice.
It's Uncle Tonte. So.
Nice. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, how about you, Tiffany? Do you have a nickname?
I don't think so. Not like, I mean, I have nicknames like Tiff, Spunky, Spicy, Salsa.
Oh, Spicy and Spunky. Salsa. Yes.
But, I mean, there's no, like, grand story behind it. Nothing like that.
But since you were the leg turner.
Oh, my God.
Right. That was your trademark move.
No, I don't think. I mean, they always called me the fighter on So You Think. Oh. The underdog.
That's a good one. That's a good
name. I was
name.
The underdog because, you know, it was the whole thing of I wasn't introduced until top 20. And so a lot of people, like, the first week were like, who is this? And I totally understood that, and I kind of just like had to fight my way to be like, hey, be, you know, because people had already picked their favorites and whatever, but I just kept fighting. I have to tell you this funny story. It's not funny, but it just kind of ties together Rock of Ages and So You Think. Mm-hmm. When I went to Green Mile, it shows on television, on the show, it showed that Debbie Allen told me I was in the top 20, mm-hmm. And the truth of the matter is that Adam Shankman is actually the one that told me I was in the top 20. And that night was the Rock of Ages premiere in LA. And he sits there with me and he's like dangling me. He's like, so you know tonight's the Rock of Ages premiere? And I was like, yeah. He goes, so if you don't make it, you can go to the premiere tonight. And I was like, yeah, like thinking in my head, like, mm-hmm. Like I wanna go, but I'm like, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And he goes, well, you can't go because you made the top 20. So that's the way. It was never televised, but that's actually how I
found out.
Yeah.
I
so
love
was,
it.
It was the same exact day, Green Mile
Inside
and
Secrets.
Wow.
Rock of Ages.
You heard it here first.
So I have a couple questions before we go.
Yeah.
What are some of the things that you kind of have grabbed from your experiences being a dancer, going through everything that you've been through, obviously, again, this young place in your life. You guys have so much more to accomplish. Mm-hmm. And you're doing groundbreaking things already, you know? And, you know, with this new climate of social media and trying to incorporate branding yourself as an artist, what kind of advice can you give our viewers? Because I know that they look up to you guys and they want to know what they can do to be like you guys.
Go first.
Okay.
Tonte, please.
Yeah.
It's your turn, Tonte.
You
go.
Honestly, I think the dancing, the career, and just being around this environment, dance is, you know, by my mentors, Rich and Tone Talego, they said dance is a language, you know, and especially when you're freestyling, is a language that to be spoken, whether you're in France, Germany, Japan, wherever you are, mm-hmm. It doesn't matter the language barrier. Mm-hmm. But the dance barrier language, if they can understand you, you're doing the right thing. So I think the most important thing is for people to realize that, especially with the social media, you know, everyone's kind of accepting this new language that's going around, this new dance forms and different styles, and you can't really put a thumb on what it is. People need to kind of stop trying to label it, this is this and this is that, and just realize it's just dance, and it's someone's interpretation to the music, and it it all comes from cultural dance to begin with. So mm-hmm. let the cultural dance continue carrying through, and let it just be natural and raw. If it's that way, then people will accept it. And if it matches the music, that's the most important thing. So make sure the music is good quality. But what I would tell the young viewers is do your music history. Mm-hmm. People, I always tell, do music it. History, young friends, music
Say it
history.
Right into the viewer's eye.
Listen, my young viewer.
Oh my gosh.
I'm giving you my Jedi powers.
Yes.
Listen to your music. Most importantly, Michael Jackson. My favorite. My favorite. But no, listen to the music. And it's really important to, like, I learned this from just this year with my mentors that, you know, they were talking about the composers. They were talking about the musicians. They were talking about the people who just did the sound for the song. And they knew all that. And I was like, yeah. When you know them, those kind of moves, then moving in the entertainment field makes it a little bit, you know, more enjoyable. Mm-hmm. I think another thing that we worked on together that was pretty awesome, and through the dancing, you know, being out here, is I met a fantastic artist named Daniel Cloud Campos.
Mm. Yep.
And we did this short he wrote called Today's a Day. And I think it was moving out here is when I started discovering who he was, and it inspired me then to pick up a camera. I was always into cameras, but watching him and how he brought his visions to life mm-hmm. through dance, but it wasn't like, here I am dancing like this. It was like Fred Astaire mm-hmm. and Gene Kelly, like, mm-hmm. I'm dancing like this.
Right.
Because the scene calls for dancing, not because I'm dancing on the scene.
Exactly.
It's different. Yeah. Yep. So it was like, it was very cool. Mm-hmm. And then to be in part of his short, just to be a part of it was cool because it was a little bit more freelance than Step Up movies because Step Up is so big.
Sure.
To see a smaller production pull together what he wanted was very cool.
He's done a TED Talks too.
Yes.
Oh, if you have time to watch a TED Talks yeah. with Daniel yeah. Campos doing his thing,
yeah.
it's great. I mean, also his wife Tamara. I mean, yes. his team, unbelievable. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yes. Very her and I, funny side note, yeah. random, her and I competed in rhythmic gymnastics
no
together.
Way.
She that went to the 92 Olympics, That's and amazing. We competed, I forgot, we went to World Championships, and we used to slide each other food under our plate when our coaches weren't looking. Yes, that's we go way back. And then all of a sudden I saw her on De La Guarda.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, that girl looks really familiar. But as a gymnast, she had the longest hair that was always up in a bun. And then in De La Guarda, she had shaved her head. And I'm like, that girl looks so familiar, but she's crazy.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
And it's so funny. We go way back, but she's a phenomenal artist as Amazing. Well. And then yeah. her and Daniel
Such a
together
great.
Just so beautifully creative. And
yeah. I love the choreography in that show.
Yes.
The choreography in that show is fantastic.
Fantastic.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
a new one in New York.
Fuerza Bruta.
Oh,
yeah, it was so good. Fantastic. We saw that.
On top
Which
of the ceiling.
Unfortunately,
and
closed.
It did.
Now. Yeah, mm-hmm. it just closed.
Which unfortunately is closed, but hopefully you guys can check it out somewhere, somehow, because it was
come back somewhere. Oh, yeah,
yeah, I'm sure. Great.
But really quick, Tiffany, any words of wisdom and advice?
I think my wisdom and advice would be a few things. First, to be the yes dancer. Be the dancer that, can you do this? Yes, I can do that. Can you do tap? Yes, I can tap. Can you do hip hop? Yes, I can do hip hop.
But don't lie about it.
But don't lie about it, yeah. So be the yes dancer, get into as much as you can, learn as much as you can.
Versatility.
Yeah, versatility. And then also, you know, that it's not rainbows and butterflies and ice cream cones. Like, you're gonna have to work hard, you know? Yeah. Like, it's not gonna just be handed to you. And I think, like, everybody sees the, you know, on Instagram, we all post, like, our jobs and everything that's awesome, but you know, we're still training all the time at the studios mm-hmm. and there's still That's auditions. Mm-hmm. You know, I remember for Hit the Floor one season, it was like, this year we need a brunette, an Asian, and a redhead. Next year we need an African-American and a blonde girl. And it's like, so if I would have auditioned the next year, I would have had zero chances of making it. Right. You know, so there's those things that come into play.
Mm-hmm.
Timing. Yeah, timing yeah. and then having perseverance and just, you know, I'm a quote girl, never let the fear of striking out keep you from playing the game.
Yeah.
Be be a better person than you were yesterday and work hard to get where you want to be and make sure that that's your work ethic.
I think the main thing too is also like being on set is a gift. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So for someone like myself who I went to college for one communications and also and be a school teacher, to then I stopped my college pursuit and came into dancing. Being on set, I still am trying to learn and teach myself. That's one thing I like to do is continue to teach myself. being on set is a gift. People, you know, they get distracted and start to complain about hours and things, but you're not learning the things around you. Take advantage of it, you know. Look at the cameras, look at the lights, look at this. I was working with the great Barry Lather. Mr. Barry Lather, I was working with him in Tennessee, and we were talking about, we were going through the set, and I was standing behind him watching it, and he goes, "You're watching me?" I go, "Yeah." He goes, "That's what I used to do. He goes, I used to watch people all the time."
Yeah. Yeah.
He goes, "I still do." Mm-hmm. It's my secret. I go, I walk around, I talk to people, I ask them what they're doing, what's their job.
Sure.
So every tour I've ever been on, I was on tour for Chris Brown in Europe, and I walk up to the director who's calling the shots and all this. And he's in the shot. I'm standing behind him. He goes, "Aren't you gonna go to your break?" And he goes, "What are you doing? Who are you?" I go, "I'm just one of the dancers. I'm just watching you direct. I just want to watch you call your shots. I want to see what you think is a good shot, and I want to see what I think is a good shot." Mm-hmm. He's like,
"Okay,
okay."
Right, I'm like, right.
I was like, but I said that's, but it's something I like to do. I've always said I would love to call an award show and see it, because I feel like, you know, sometimes people who call award shows, I'm not completely educated on this, but I'm speaking outside of an entertainment and just a fan. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I miss the dancing scenes. I don't really care to see the audience members celebrating. Yeah. I want to see what the artist is doing, what the choreographer is doing, what the set design did, why the costume designer made the costumes. Don't look. I don't want to see what that is on the red carpet for 3 hours. Mm-hmm. I want to stay on the stage. Shoot it better. Let me see it better.
Yeah, that's always an issue, actually, capturing dance. It's definitely an art form. Mm-hmm.
It's an art.
So maybe one day you will be calling
the
shots.
No, one day I will. Absolutely.
There you go. Dream big. You guys, please, thank you so much for coming and being a part of our show.
Yeah, thank you.
Pop Dance Life, this is a new platform for dancers to come and, you know, learn about what you guys are up to. Where can they follow you? What are your Twitter, Instagram handlers, Facebook?
You can follow me at Tiffany.Maher on Instagram, and on Twitter it's Dance9Tiffany.
Great. And I'm at Tony Bellissimo across the board. On Twitter at Tony Bellissimo.
Okay.
BELLISSIMO. Yes, it's beautiful. Thank you. You can follow us at Tremaine Dance.
Yes.
The convention we teach for is at Tremaine Dance, or you can look us up, www.tremainedance.com is our entire schedule, everything like that.
Come dance with
us. Very cool.
And come dance with us, come learn, and come see, you know, the legendary Joe Tremaine and his thing.
Well, you guys are amazing. Thank you so much for coming and blessing
us. Thank you
very
much.
With your presence, you guys.
Thank you.
Great.
All right.
Thank you.
Bye.
And that's great.
Bye,
nice, you guys.
Bye. Bye.